In the previous video, we introduced the 3-5 PV technologies and discussed the structural properties of the 3-5 absorber materials. In this video, we will look at the electrical and optical properties of the 3-5 materials. To that end, you will learn about the electronic band dispersion diagram of gallium arsenide. We will also look at the absorption characteristic of gallium arsenide and compare it with that of crystalline silicon to understand the difference between both materials. Let's first begin with a small recap of the band dispersion diagram that was introduced earlier in this course. In a crystalline lattice, the atoms are arranged in a certain pattern that repeats itself. However, the pattern is not the same in every direction. Depending on how you cut through the lattice, you could, for example, end up with the 1-0-0 surface where the silicon atom has two backbones and two valence electrons pointing to the front. Another possibility is the 1-1-1 surface. Here, every silicon atom has three backbones and one valence electron pointing towards the plane normal. The exact energy level of the conduction and valence band depends on these directions. In other words, the exact energy level of the conduction band and valence band depends on the position of an electron in the crystalline lattice. This figure shows the different positions or direction that an electron can occupy in a crystal lattice. This also means that the momentum of the charge carriers can differ with the various directions in the lattice. Here, the L direction represents the 1-1-1 surface, and the X direction represents the 1-0-0 surface. As we know, an electron can move through a crystalline lattice if it has enough momentum. We can therefore build up a graph with the energy level on the vertical axis and the momentum of the charge carriers on the horizontal axis. The charge carrier momentum is also known as the crystal momentum. By solving the Bloch function for certain positions in the lattice, you can obtain the energy levels of the conduction band and valence band edges. By connecting these energy levels with the specific crystal momentum of the various crystal orientations, you obtain the electronic band dispersion diagram of a material. The white area represents the energy levels in the forbidden band gap. The band gap of a material is defined as the difference between the lowest energy point of the conduction band and the highest point of the valence band. For silicon, these two points are not vertically aligned. This band gap is an indirect band gap because the charge carriers must change in energy and momentum to be excited from the valence to the conduction band. The dispersion diagram of gallium arsenide is quite different from that of crystalline silicon. Gallium arsenide has three well-defined valleys at the X, gamma, and L position of the crystalline lattice. The smallest band gap occurs at the gamma valley, where the valence band aligns vertically with the lowest energy level of the conduction band. Gallium arsenide is therefore a direct bandgap material. For a direct bandgap material, only transfer of energy is required to excite an electron from the valence to the conduction band, but no transfer of momentum is required. At its lowest point, the bandgap of gallium arsenide is equal to 1.42 electron volts. The direct bandgap of gallium arsenide of 1.42 electron volts strongly affect its absorption characteristics. Plotted here is the absorption coefficient of crystalline silicon as a function of the photon wavelength. This red line on the horizontal axis indicates the wavelength corresponding to the bandgap energy of crystalline silicon. With a bandgap of 1.12 electron volt, the corresponding wavelength is around 1100 nanometers. Gallium arsenide has a high bandgap energy corresponding to a wavelength of about 870 nanometers. The visible part of the spectrum where the solar irradiance is the most powerful is indicated by the colorful banner. As we can see, the absorption coefficient of gallium arsenide in the visible spectrum is significantly higher than that of silicon. The same is true for indium phosphide, which has a direct band gap corresponding to a wavelength of 925 nanometers. This means that for a similar absorber layer thickness, the 3-5 materials will absorb a larger fraction of the incident light. This is because for an indirect bandgap material, it's less likely that a photon with an energy exceeding the bandgap can excite an electron, since it requires a change in both energy and momentum. As you may recall, silicon also has a direct bandgap of 3.4 electron volts, which corresponds to 364 nanometers. For energy above this direct bandgap, silicon absorbs just as much as the 3-5 materials. So, in a direct bandgap material, an electron only requires a change in energy to be excited. The reverse is also true. An excited electron in a direct bandgap material does not require a change in momentum to recombine. The dominant recombination mechanism is therefore radiative recombination. Shockley-Rideau recombination is caused by defects and is present in any material. In a good quality single-junction gallium arsenide solar cell, the Shockley-Rideau recombination can be ignored. However, as you will learn in the next videos, Shockley-Rideau recombination might become significant in certain type of multi-junction devices. Finally, Auger recombination. As Auger recombination is a 3-particle process, the Auger recombination rate strongly depends on the charge carrier densities for the electrons n and holes p. Under normal circumstances, Auger recombination is insignificant for direct bandgap materials. However, for an n-type semiconductor under high injection condition, when a very large amount of charge carriers are generated, Auger recombination might also become important for direct bandgap materials such as gallium arsenide. Such high injection levels occur, for example, for concentrator photovoltaics. Time for a recap. In this video, we learned about the electrical properties of the 3-5 materials. We first looked into their electronic band dispersion diagram and learned that these materials are direct bandgap materials. Further, we also learned that this direct bandgap gives rise to radiative recombination losses and a high absorption coefficient, which are characteristics that have to be kept in mind while designing these solar cells. With this, we complete the study on the properties of 3-5 materials. In the next video, we will look into the application of 3-5 materials in multi-junction solar cells.